Hi there and welcome to another video from Hegarty Maths. It's Mr. Hegarty here, and in this video we're solving two-step equations involving division this time. Let's start with something we've worked on previously. We've previously written equations involving division from a sentence, and I'm thinking of a number sentence. Pause the video and check you can think of that I'm thinking of a number sentence relating to these two. Well, hopefully you got, I'm thinking of a number. Now, what did I do to it first, this x that I might introduce? I divided by 3 and then I added 2 and got 12. But in this case, I was thinking of a number and first I added the 2 and divided by 3. And it's really important when you look at equations like this, you know the order that happened to x so that when we're solving it and doing the inverse process, we know what to do. So in this case, because you originally divided your x by 3 and added 2, when you're using the balance method, going backwards to solve for x, you're going to subtract 2 and then multiply by 3. But in this case, because you originally added 2 and afterwards divided by 3, when you're going backwards and solving via the balance method, the first thing you're going to do to both sides is multiply by 3 and then you're going to subtract 2. Right, let's have a go at some questions where we use this idea. Pause at any stage and try yourself. First one. Well, just think what happened to x just before you get going. The first thing was you divided by 3 and afterwards you added 2 when you were setting up the problem. So to solve the problem and do the inverse, we're going to subtract 2 and then multiply by 3 afterwards. So let's do that. Let's subtract 2 off both sides, laying it out really carefully. And what are we going to get left with on the left hand side? Well, we're going to get left with x over 3. And on the right hand side, 12 take away 2 is 10. We've done that. Now we're going to multiply both sides by 3. So do that here. Multiply this side by 3. Multiply this side by 3. The 3's will cancel here. And I'm going to get my answer. X is therefore 10 multiplied by 3, which is 30. Obviously, before we go on, let's check it's right. 30 divided by 3 is 10. 10 add 2 is 12. Happy days. Got it right. Checked it. Next one. Pause. Have a go. Now, this time, hopefully you can see what happened to x. The first thing that happened to x is you added 2. Afterwards, you divided by 3 this time. And that was when you set up the problem. So going backwards this time, we're going to multiply by 3 and then subtract 2. So let's do it. Let's multiply both sides by 3 as our first step. And that would make the 3 cancel with the 3 dividing there. And we'd just be left with, on the left-hand side, x add 2. Is equal to 12 multiplied by 3 is 36. Done the multiply by 3. Now let's subtract the 2 off both sides. Subtract 2 here. Subtract 2 here. What am I left with? X is therefore equal to 36. Subtract 2, which is 34. And we're done. Let's check it's actually right. 34 add 2 is 36. 36 divided by 3 gives me 12, my original problem. I've checked it and I'm very happy with that. Just a tiny point to note here. Sometimes you may see the numerator like that, 2 add x, okay? Because addition's commutative, I always just, as my first line of working, would write the x to the left-hand side. And that's something I'm going to show in an example later. So it's just a little warning for you in advance. Next one, pause, have a go. Right, what happened to x? Well, the first thing is it divided by 5 and then you subtracted 2 when you were setting it up. So to do the inverse process, we're going to add 2 and then multiply by 5 after. Let's add 2 to both sides. Nice, neat column like that. And what are we going to get? Well, on the left-hand side, we've still got our x divided by 5. Negative 5 add 2 is negative 3. Now we're going to multiply both sides by 5, multiply by 5 here, multiply by 5 here. The 5 multiplying cancels with the 5 dividing, and we're just left with x on the left-hand side is equal to negative 3 multiplied by 5 is negative 15, and we're done. Check it's right before we go on. Negative 15 divided by 5, negative 3. Negative 3 take away 2, negative 5. Checked it, do a smiley face to say you've done it. Next one. Pause, have a go. Right, guys, this is the one I was talking about earlier. When I see that, because addition is commutative, I just start off by just writing the x to the left hand side. It just helps me think in the right way. So that's what I do as my first line. Then I think what happened to x along the way. Well, the first thing that happened to x is that you added 2 and then you divided by 5 when you were setting up the problem. So going backwards, the first thing we're going to do is multiply both sides by 5 and subtract 2. Multiply by 5 here, multiply by 5 here. What do we get? The 5's cancel, and we're just left with x add 2 is equal to negative 15. So I've done this first bit here. Now I'm going to subtract 2 off both sides. So subtract 2 here, subtract 2 here. And I'm going to get left with x on the left hand side is therefore equal to negative 15. Take away another 2 is negative 17. Go up here and check it works. 2 add negative 17. 2 add negative 17 is like 2 take away 17, because adding a negative is like subtracting a positive. 2 subtract 17 is negative 15. Divided by 5 is negative 3. I checked it. I'm happy and it's done. And that's it for this video. Thanks for watching.